want to thank J-Mag, I want to thank Jeff, I want to thank Madge, and of course, our Alpha Director for this opportunity. I started Salad Master without knowing anybody. Adeola, who was the team top team leader, came to cook for me April 28th. But before then, it was her husband actually who told me about the opportunity. He just casually said it. He said, I just went for something, one site something. I called him and I was like, tell me now, what's the site something I'm interested? And he told me about it and she called me and said, can I come that day? I was like, okay, that day is not convenient, but you can come the next day. That was on a Monday she called me. And on a Tuesday, she and Lorena came and they cooked for me. That was on April 28th. And May 3rd, I cooked for Victoria. She's here too. So they told me, okay, when you come, you have to cook for 6 people and the rest. But here was the problem. Cooking for 6 people wasn't the problem at first, but I don't know anybody because I just came from Ukraine as a medical doctor. I'm a gynecologist by training. And the war I brought me, so I just come, no friends, nobody. And I was like, how am I going to cook for 6 people? You need individuals, these are living people. And I just come from maybe dropping my son straight home. Then I was even looking for jobs because, you know, before you work here, you have to write either your PLAB, you know, you have to write a couple of exams before you can work as a medical doctor here. And I had not written those exams. I even still have not written those exams up till now. So I was like, okay, let me just find something to do pending when I'm psychologically ready for those exams, because the war, and then shortly before the war, I was cash drained. When I say cash drained, like zero, because I had just opened my clinic back home in Nigeria, and you know, in Nigeria, you cannot have loans, so it means taking everything I'd worked as a doctor in Ukraine to go open that hospital and thinking, okay, you're coming back, of course, you continue your job is waiting for you, and just 1 month into that job, the war broke out. So it was impossible for me to stay there, so we had to move here. And I want to share with you the beauty of starting over, because it was like from ground zero. So I was very happy when Adeola came and Lorena, they were cooking. At first they were trying to tell me, okay, you know, you fry your chicken without oil, you do this, but my mind was racing. As they were talking about it, two things were in my head, because John had mentioned in passing about the opportunity. So I was looking like, okay, I'm going to make money from there. But then again, I was looking at it, I was like, but this is health. This is cholesterol, this oil coming out from our electric skillet, this is cholesterol, so that means this is somehow similar to medicine. If they can do it, that they're not in medicine, then I can do it. But I had a major challenge, which was not knowing anybody. And so when she left and said, we have to cook for 6 people, the only person I knew was somebody in my church who was always also turned to be a friend and a sister, was Victoria. So I called her, I said, Victoria, there's something I'm coming to tell you. Some people are coming to cook in your house. It's about healthy cooking. I don't know much about it because they just told me 2 days ago, can I come? And she said, oh, no, don't come today, but you can come 2 days later. And that's how I went to her house. And the journey began. But then I had cooked for Victoria. Who else am I going to cook for? Because Victoria now wants to join the business, so no referrals. What am I going to do? If Victoria wasn't joining the business, I could possibly get referrals from Victoria, but she's joining the business, so what do I do? So then I was coming back from her house that evening. Janet cooked for Victoria. So I was coming back from there, and Janet dropped me in my house because we're neighbors just a few blocks away. But as I was coming down, and Janet was like, okay, we'll see you for your next dinner, try to book. You know, Janet is always very positive. You know, she did, but a lot of things were going through my head. Yes, she was being positive, we'll go cook the other shows, but in my head I was like, who am I cooking for? Then I looked around me. I was like, well, these are human beings around me. But unfortunately, or I don't know if to say fortunately, they are Pakistan people. I live around them. So I said, but I can start for my very neighbor. She's friendly. I live at 28, she's 26. So I went there and I knocked in the very next morning. And I said, this man, I just started working for XYZ, working for JMAC. It's a health and nutrition company. She was like, but is it a hospital? I said, no, because she knows I'm a doctor. I said, it's not a hospital, but we'll tell you about healthy living and healthy cooking. Can I please come and cook? She was like, okay, you can come, but oh no, not this week, next week. Meanwhile, I have 15 days. I'm like, wow. She's saying next week, that will be 15 days. So you mean in the 15th day, I'm going to cook for just the second person? How am I going to finish my plasso? So I drop my son in the bus, in a bus stop. The school bus picks him and they drop him. Then I looked around the school bus now. That was the next morning after Isma had told me, come in almost like 2 weeks' time. I said, but these are parents here, I could speak to them. So I spoke to one that we normally chit-chat, like we greet, we're quite friendly. I spoke to her and I told her, please, can I come cook in your house? I work for a health and food nutrition company. Same story I told Isma. And she was like, yeah, you can come. But then again, in passing, someone from the office had told me, I can't remember who, that, oh, the Pakistani market, if you go there, they will just, I was like, it doesn't matter. All I need, they said, cook 6 shows, that's all they said. So in my head, I wasn't even planning to sell or anything. I just wanted to cook the 6 shows and then get on the bonus program. And I cooked for the lady, and from there, I went to church on a Sunday. And I saw people in church again. I was like, these are people too. So I started talking to people in church, and so that was how I was able to finish my blast off, and then I was now able to finish my bonus set challenge in time by talking, just talking to people I don't know. You know, it's difficult when you start with your cold market. And I think that was a training ground for me because I didn't start with any warm market. So because they were my cold market, I don't care where you come from now, I don't care where you live, I don't care your background, I would walk into your house and in my head will give you the best presentation there is to give because I started with a cold market. So it doesn't matter to me whether you smile or not, I would walk into your house and I believe that I will make a sale. But then there's something I want to tell us about training because that helped me. I was selling, yes, but I wasn't selling big sales or good sales. I started when, after the training, when I, you know, when you're now self-sufficient, I think the first 2 shows were beginner set. Then I went for training and Marge now started teaching us how, okay, if you're showing the sets, this is what you should do. Because usually when I get to the executive chef set, I just flip over because I believe they won't buy. You know, I believe it's too expensive. So I don't even tell them about it. I just flip over quickly. And then start going to, you know, the lower sets that I believe, okay, they'll be comfortable to buy. But then Matt told us, when you go, you start from the executive set, show them all the sets you have, and then you continue and go down the line. And so I just, after that training, the very next show I had, even though I had some fear, I showed the executive set, but I quickly also passed it over and went to the master set. And then the man said, go back. And so I went back and he said, this is what we would buy. I just thought I didn't hear him. I said, what did you say? He said, I will buy this because I've looked at it. If I have to get the master's for 6112 and the executive for 11608, I think this is cheaper because my wife is a baker and I'll be able to buy everything. So I went on now, it was now like series, it was in successions. So I was now selling chef sets as if I was selling beginner sets. And that was because of a change mindset from the training. So I was not able to start, and you know, with the training and with selling bigger sets, confident. I started having confidence that, okay, I could walk into anywhere and I could, you know, be able to make a sale. Now, what's my motivation if you ask? Why do I go on to be able to get builders or to be able to sell? My motivation is I look at our Lord Jesus Christ, because I'm a believer, if I must say this. And I look at our Lord Jesus Christ, and there was a part in scripture that says, for the goal that was set before him, he endured the cross. So because of the goal I see in the future, I see me as a dealer. I see me as a top dealer. So because of So because of that, I'm able to withstand any obstacle because I don't drive yet and I have a little son, so sometimes from school, I'm changing him in the car. We're rushing in between shows. Doing 3 shows in a day, sometimes in a week, I'm doing 10 shows in between, changing my son, giving him food in the car, going for those shows. What is driving me? I see the end goal. And then I also have mentors. I see Janet and I'm saying, okay, Janet, do it, then I can do it. So from July, Janet was like, Rose, try the 30-30. And I was like, Janet, I don't think I can do this 30-30. She said, don't worry, you can do it. And so consistently, since July, I've been doing 30-30 shows consistently. And it's like it's nothing because I don't even remember it. It's when I look at the CRM, like currently now, we're not to the end of the month, but I think I've done 26 already. So I don't remember that, oh, there's a 30-30. I'm just continuing because I told Janet that, okay, you've done so many. I'm coming after you, so I'll be able to catch up with you. So I will try to do the 30-30 and continuously do that 30-30. Now, if you think about, there are some people who, somebody mentioned here that there's one leg in, one leg out. There are a lot of us like that. When I mean one leg in, one leg out, they're not giving their all to Salad Master because they feel, oh, what if I go and I don't make a sale and I need to, you know, pay my bills, I need to do this. Scripture also says, as a man thinketh, so he is. I don't walk into a show believing I will not sell. I walk into a show believing I'm going, three things would happen. Either I would leave an impression with you that you would think of me days after I've left, even if you don't buy. Or secondly, I would make a sale. And then thirdly, I may make that sale, but I will also try my best to share the opportunity with you and get you into the business. So you have to have this mindset that I'm going for this show, this is what I want, and three things must happen. And believe you me, anytime I go for a show, even if I don't make a sale, I either get a builder, or at least I know that I have left an impression, I have changed life in that home. So if you have that mindset and you walk into that house, you would know that what you're doing, it's working. It's not every time that it's about the money. Yes, the money is good, but if you have this mindset that I'm going to share something that is good, the product will sell itself. But have the mindset that I'm going to share something that is good with somebody. I'm going into this home and their lives will not remain the same. Every other thing follows. So you have to have eyes on the prize. If you're thinking, I'm a medical doctor, I've worked as a gynecologist, I finished since 2012, I've worked as a gynecologist, in fact, in the post-op department, I was a team leader there. That is where women who have lost so much blood were managing them, so they're in between life and death and all. If that was my passion, it still is my passion, but if I can see this opportunity in Salad Master and give it my full time, give it my all, I do not think there's anyone here that cannot do the same. It just starts with your mindset. It starts with your mind. The first thing you should ask yourself is, why am I here? Why am I in the business? Am I in the business just because some people say, oh, Salad Master, and I just feel okay, I should just do it? Or you are in the business because you see the end goal. You end goal, when I say the end goal, when I say the price, it's not just about, okay, maybe becoming a dealer for the fun of it or for the money attached, no. It's because of the lives you would change by being in that position. When you have the finances or when you have the opportunities and everything, the perks that come with it, the life back home or the people you know or even people you don't know that you'll be able to change, it's worth it. It's worth it for you to get out of your bed. It's worth it for you to go cook that show. And I cannot overemphasize training enough. For most of us have different professions. Some were nurses, some were doctors, different professions. We all read to get here. So if you read to get your certificate, you can read the carrot test. You can read, you know, the price. And I don't know if you do that, but we in JMAC, we do what we call the solution page. We do the carrot test and we do the price delivery. Those three things are key. It's very easy. You can read it, you can memorize it, and you can go in there. I always tell people in my team, anyway, hello team Ace. I always tell people in my team that if you just book it and show up. All you need to do is book. Book and show up. If you book and show up, anything can happen in Salad Master. That has been my journey. That has been my story. And the beauty of starting over is you are able to tell your story all over again like I've just done. So please, I want to tell all of us that when you go back home or even on your ride back home, book that show and show up. God bless you. Keep it.